Some shows don't need a celebrity narrator to introduce the show, but this show does. In a world filled with endless opportunities, why would two men who have built 13 multi-million dollar businesses altruistically invest 5 hours per day to teach you the best practice business systems and moves that you can use? Because they believe in you, and they have a lot of time on their hands. They started from the bottom, now they're here. It's the Thrive Time Show, starring the former U.S. Small Business Administration's Entrepreneur of the Year, Clay Clark, and the entrepreneur trapped inside an optometrist's body, Dr. Robert Zollner. Two men, 8 kids, co-created by 2 different women, 13 multi-million dollar businesses.
We started from the bottom, now we're here. We started from the bottom, and we'll show you how to get here. Started from the bottom, now we're here. We started from the bottom, now we're here.
We started from the bottom, now we're at the top, teaching you the systems to get what we got. Colton Dixon's on the hooks, I break down the books. Z's bringing some wisdom and the good looks. As the father of 5, that's why I'm alive. So if you see my wife and kids, please tell them hi. It's the CNC up on your radio. And now 3, 2, 1, here we go.
We started from the bottom, now we're here. We started from the bottom, and we'll show you how to get here. Started from the bottom, now we're here.
Thank you so much for being here, my friend.
Thank you, Clay.
And we are talking about putting first things first, which I think you are uniquely qualified to talk about. Oh. Because you are a guy who puts faith first, and correct me if I'm wrong here, but it's faith, family, then finances.
Absolutely.
In that order?
In that order.
And it seems as though not only do you say that, but you do that.
I try,
yes. And it's amazing, but as I've met a few people that have known you for a long time, they've said, well, he puts faith, family, and finances first. I mean, faith is first, family second. Or, you know, it's interesting that you're known for that. That's something you're about. It's something you believe in. And here we are in a busy world. And if you're a business owner, your phone rings, email doesn't stop, there's employees who are freaking out, there's someone who needs to be fired, there's always another conference to attend, there's always stuff going on. And I've met numerous millionaires in everyday success stories, and they all talk about priorities and the importance of scheduling them. But specifically, how do you prioritize the following 5 items in your mind? I'm going to give them to you.
Okay.
Finances, faith, family, relationships, and physical fitness.
Wow.
So where in the 5, where does finances fall when you talk about the faith, the family, the finances?
It's 4th in that list.
4th?
Yeah.
Okay. Now, what about physical fitness? Where does that fall in?
That's 3rd in that list.
3rd? Okay. What about faith?
That's 1st.
What about family?
Family is 2nd.
Okay. So, and then relationships kind of took in the...
I think when you separate relationships, to me, family, relationships, that's kind of the same thing.
Okay.
I think that the only real relationships you have are the family ones. Mm. The ones outside, you're always building relationships with other people. So I don't really see those in the same way.
Okay.
And maybe, you know, I know there are people out there who don't have as much family around them.
Yeah.
But I try to keep family around me all the time, and that's where most of my relationship energy goes.
That's interesting. Now, do you schedule time in your schedule for faith?
Oh, absolutely. Yeah, that's kind of the first thing I try to schedule. I mean, usually it starts in the morning. I try to get up first thing in the morning and spend that first half an hour, 45 minutes, either in prayer or reading, or just kind of meditating on what I've been reading, and trying to figure out, what are you trying to say about me in this day, and how do I approach the people, and what's going on, Lord? You know, so that's my first, you know, usually 30, 45 minutes of the day.
And not to get super scientific, because my brain can only go so deep, yeah. But it seems like when you're praying, you probably can't be on Facebook, or you probably can't be on the phone because you're praying.
No, it's pretty hard to do those two things.
So you turn your phone off when you're praying? Is that what you're doing?
I mean, oh, absolutely.
Okay.
No, I have the only thing I have when I'm praying is my Bible. I'll have it sitting right there.
Yeah.
And I'll have my, you know, whatever, my face in the I use an ottoman. So my face in the ottoman and my Bible right there.
That's it.
That's it.
Now, okay. So now we move on to family. Do you schedule time for family every day?
Absolutely. You know, I prioritize the children's events, their needs first. And then my wife and I try to do everything together. So when we, you know, if there's an event, if there's a practice or something, we try to, you know, do those things together.
And then what about when we get here to this area of our relationships, and, or I guess our you know, kind of our financial relationship. Mm-hmm. So it's business. It's business, but it's like a business relationship or something you're working on. Does that sort of, do you schedule time for that too? Like there's time where you're doing business and there's time when you're not doing business?
There is, yeah, I mean, I would separate the business times from other times, from family times. I mean, if I'm spending time with my son, I'm generally not doing any business. Although I might be at a game and answer an email.
Okay.
But I try to be fully present when I'm with my family.
Being fully present when you're with them.
Yes, absolutely. That's a real key. I mean, because they can tell when you're not paying attention to them, and they can, you know, my wife can tell when I'm not listening. I hear sometimes that, you know, you're not listening to me. And she's right. I might be thinking about something else. So it's clear to them when you're not with them.
I think it's huge though, because after you retired, you started a school. Mm-hmm. And how many kids went to school at this school?
We started off with 60 children back 12 years ago, and we've added a class a year, and now there's in the Carver Idea is through about 320 students.
320 students. So with 320 students, there's probably always an emergency. There's probably always somebody who needs to be hired or a staff issue. There's always stuff going on. Yeah. But even though there's all these demands, you still schedule things first things first. You still put the family in there. You still put the faith. You still schedule all that.
Absolutely. Well, when it was a private school, I did more of the actual running of the school. Now it's a charter school. It's a part of the IDEA network. So IDEA actually runs the school on a day-to-day basis now, so that frees me up now to be more on the regional board, help them build more schools here in San Antonio, and be a part of kind of the longer-term planning process.
Now, Benjamin Franklin, one of our founding fathers, for those of you who don't know who Benjamin Franklin is, he said, "By failing to prepare, you are preparing to fail." It seems common sense, but mm-hmm. yet I see a lot of business owners who show up at their meetings, and they obviously haven't prepared for the meeting. I see them not able to get to their, like for my kids as an example, my son plays hockey. Mm. And if I'm not on time for the game, it's my fault. And that stinks when I do it, because I know that I didn't prepare properly.
Right.
And I didn't put a realistic travel time in my schedule.
I'm guilty. Yeah.
You know?
I understand that. Yes, very
and
so, well.
But it's my fault, though. And yeah. I could have done. So it seems like that you have to probably devote at least a half hour a day just to planning out your day. Do you do this?
Well, in the morning, I think that's a real key. When you're looking at your schedule and I'm trying to figure out how am I going to get these things done? I mean, you would do that if you have a flight out today, and what time am I going to leave? How long does it take you to say, okay, I need 45 minutes between the time I leave the house and the time I get to the airport? You have to think through those things sometimes. And so, I don't think it takes a ton of time to plan those things out.
Now, you know, with my life, with all the different business ventures I'm involved in, it takes me about an hour a day to kind of, you know, plan everything out. Mm. But I find my day is much more productive when I take the time to really schedule mm-hmm. everything.
Yeah.
And Zig Ziglar, the late, great success author, he said, lack of direction, not lack of time, mm-hmm. is the problem.
Yeah.
We all have 24 hours a day. Yet I see a lot of entrepreneurs who say, well, I'd love to have a great family, but I can't because I'm focused on my business.
Yeah.
Or I'd love to have a great business, but I'm focused on my family. Do you agree the idea there's time to get things done if we just prioritize and schedule our time efficiently?
Absolutely. But you need to make your expectations realistic.
Okay.
If you're not going to devote a ton of time to your business, you have to be ready and prepared for a lesser production in your business. If you are not going to be committed to devoting an amount of time to your family, you have to be prepared for a lack of depth in your relationships. So there's trade-offs But you build your own expectation, and you understand when you build your plan, that's what you're setting yourself up for.
I think it's a difficult conversation, but for people who are watching this who are maybe not scheduling first things first, I've seen it rip apart two marriages of people that I know very well, where they just never scheduled date nights, they never scheduled time to talk, they never scheduled time with their kids, and the family just was ripped apart. And I've seen business owners that never scheduled time to have a staff meeting. Just never had time to make a marketing calendar, or never had time to, and then it just falls apart.
Right.
So it seems like when we don't put first things first, all of a sudden we start to see emergencies, right? I mean, that's...
Yeah, no, absolutely. It can be an issue. And, you know, I think you definitely need to commit time to understanding what things are first, understanding what you need to prioritize. What do you want to accomplish? So, you know, I think if, you know, in your business, understand that what Zig Ziglar said is true. You don't expect to succeed if you fail to prepare, you know? So, you know, you have to understand what is important. What are my trade-offs? That was one thing I learned at the Naval Academy. You cannot do everything. They put so many things on your plate your first 2 years there that you know you're going to fail at something. Okay. So what am I prepared to succeed at? And what am I prepared to take the brunt of the responsibility for when I don't get it done? And I think that was the pressure. That was the kind of balance that you learned the first couple of years at school. And it helped me go forward, understanding that, yes, some things I'm not going to get done, and I'm going to take the heat for it.
You spend a lot of time with your family. I know you like to have a lot of family around you.
Right.
And so you've seen members of your family, extended family, probably go through some crisis and go through some good times and bad times. If I was a family member of yours and you were kind of mentoring me, and I'd asked you for feedback, and I'm saying, David, I feel like I'm overworked. I don't have enough time to get my job done. I feel like I'm not able to spend enough time with my family. I feel like I don't have enough time to go work out. I just feel like in every area I'm just spread too thin.
Right.
What would you say to somebody who's going through that right now?
I would say, number one, you probably need to slow down. Number two, can you live with less? Because you're going to have to slow it down. You're trying to do too many things. And I would say to a person like that, they don't have their priorities straight. They don't know what's important because they're trying to do everything to please everybody. And I think God has given us just what we need. And it's really that we don't need to go out and please everybody. We don't need to. There's a lot of people that have opinions on what I think you should do and how I think your business should go. And this is what Well, that's all well and good for you, but that doesn't necessarily work for me. So as long as I know what my priorities are and what I want to accomplish, then I can put those things first. And the rest of the stuff, just take the heat for it.
I've heard you say that with success, the idea here is that you can't do all things at one time. There's all these great ideas, but you can't do them all.
Right.
You kind of have to do one thing and then the next thing. Could you talk just a little bit about your philosophy towards this? I mean, about doing one thing first or?
Yeah, I mean, it's, you know, people always talk about all this multitasking stuff, and I'm not sure I really understand what that is. I think that, you know, you can do one thing and you can do it really well, and then you can move on and you can do another thing and you can do it really well, and then you can move to another thing. And so to me, that's kind of how I guide my day. I think, okay, I'm going to try to be the best I can at what I do, but I might have to limit the things that I'm able to do. And fortunately, my wife for me is a great resource in that. She helps me curve those things down. And so I try to be as good as I can when I make myself available.
Let it be public record on this camera here that I want to thank your wife for letting you be here today. Because
good.
I know how important your family is. And I think it's awesome that you're taking the time out to mentor, you know, millions of people all over the planet who really want to hear these things and learn these concepts that it took you a full NBA career to learn a lot of these principles.
It did. It really did.
And I just can't thank you enough, but thank you so much, Dave. Appreciate it.
Thanks, Clay.
All right, JT. So hypothetically, in your mind, what is the purpose of having a business?
To get you to your goals. So it's a vehicle to get you to your destination.
Whoa. And would you need profits to get there? I mean, when you have a business that's successful, in your expert opinion, would you need profits to get your to your goals.
Yeah, because if you have a $15 million business, but you have $15 million of expenses, it's kind of pointless.
Holy crap.
All right, so the question I would have here for you, if you could take, like, I don't know, 10 minutes or less and see if you could save $3,000 a year by reducing your credit card fees, would you do it?
Yes, absolutely.
Holy crap.
Why would somebody out there who's listening right now who has a sane mind, why would they not go to thrivetimeshow.com/credit-card, thrivetimeshow.com/credit-card, to schedule a 10-minute consultation to see if they can reduce their credit card fees by at least $3,000 a year?
Why would they not do it?
Yeah, why would they not do it?
Maybe because they didn't understand how you said the website.
This tree is a symbol of the spirit of the Griswold family Christmas.
No, that's clear. Okay, so that could be true. So I encourage everybody to check out thrivetimeshow.com/credit-card, thrivetimeshow.com/credit-card. What would be another reason why someone would not be willing to take 10 minutes to compare rates to see if they could save $3,000 or more on credit card fees?
Maybe they think it is a waste of time and that it won't. It's not possible.
There's somebody out there that's making more than $3,000 every 10 minutes, and they're like, nah, that's not worth my time.
Hello. We getting there at money. We getting there at money.
There's probably someone out there.
Okay.
They would think that.
Well, I'll just tell you, folks, if you're out there today and you're making less than $3,000 per 10 minutes, I would highly recommend that you go to thrivetimeshow.com/credit-card because you can compare rates, you can save money. And, you know, the big goal, in my opinion, of building a business is to create time freedom and financial freedom. And in order to do that, you have to maximize your profits.
Holy crap.
Now, one way to maximize your profits is to increase your revenue. Another way to do it is to decrease your expenses.
It's a profit deal. It takes the pressure off.
JT, is there any other reason why somebody would not be willing to take 10 minutes to compare rates to see if they could save a total of $3,000 a year on average?
I am at a loss and I cannot think of any other.
Shampoo is better. I go on first and clean the hair. Conditioner is better. I leave the hair silky and smooth. Oh, really, fool? Really? Stop looking at me, Swan.
Well, let me tell you a good story here real quick here. I actually, years ago, compared rates with this company here called IPS. It's Integrated Payment Services. And I scheduled a consultation. I don't know that I was skeptical. I just thought, whatever, I'll take 10 minutes. I'll compare rates.
I can't tell.
You can tell me I'm a doctor.
No, I mean, I'm just not sure.
Or can't you take a guess?
Well, not for another 2 hours.
You can't take a guess for another 2 hours?
And in my case, my particular case, I save over $20,000 a year.
Holy crap.
Wow.
Which is, groceries when my wife goes to the organic stores.
Find everything you need today?
Yeah.
Great, okay.
Oh God, no.
Everything okay, ma'am?
It's just that you've only scanned a few items and it's already $60. I'm so scared.
Okay, I'm a trained professional, ma'am. I've scanned a lot of groceries. I need you to stay with me.
It's just that my in-laws are in town and they want a charcuterie board.
Well, this isn't gonna be easy, so I need you to be brave, all right? What's your name?
Patricia.
Trisha, all right, I need you to take a deep breath. We're about to do the cheese.
You know, that's the difference between eating organic and not organic. So because my wife eats organic, I had to take the 10 minutes needed to compare rates to save the $20,000 a year on credit card fees just for one of my companies.
One question, what's the brand name of the clock?
The brand name of the clock, Rod. Do we have
it? Brand name
of
the clock. It's an elegant from Ridgeway. It's from Ridgeway.
Let's buy
the clock
and sell the fireplace.
So I encourage everybody out there, go to thrivetimeshow.com/credit-card. You schedule a free consultation, request information. A member of our team will call you. They'll schedule a free consultation. It should take you 10 minutes or less. And they're going to compare rates and see if they can't save you more than $3,000 a year off of your credit card processing.
You were hoping what?
I wouldn't owe you money at the end of the day.
No, you don't owe us money.
Because at the end of the day, the goal of a business is to create time freedom and financial freedom. In order to do that, you need to create additional profits.
of new customers that we've had is up 411% over last year. We are Jared and Jennifer Johnson. We own Platinum Pest and Lawn and are located in Owosso, Oklahoma. And we have been working with Thrive for business coaching for almost a year now.
Yeah. So what we want to do is we want to share some wins with you guys that we've had by working with Thrive. First of all, we're on the top page of Google now. Okay. I just want to let you know what type of accomplishment this is. Our competition, Orkin, Terminix, they're both $1.3 billion companies. They both have 2,000 to 3,000 pages of content attached to their website. So to basically go from virtually non-existent on Google to up on the top page is really saying something. But that's come by being diligent to the systems that Thrive has, by being consistent and diligent on doing podcasts and staying on top of those podcasts to really help with getting up on with their listing and ranking there with Google.
And also, we've been trying to get Google reviews, you know, asking our customers for reviews. And now we're the highest rated and most reviewed pest and lawn company in the Tulsa area. And that's really helped with our conversion rate. And the number of new customers that we've had is up 411% over last year.
Wait, say that again. How much are we up? 411%. Okay. So 411% we're up with our new customers. Amazing.
Right. So not only do we have more customers calling in, we're able to close those deals at a much higher rate than we were before. Right now, our closing rate is about 85%, and that's largely due to, first of all, like our Google reviews that we've gotten. People really see that our customers are happy, but also we have a script that we follow. And so when customers call in, they get all the information that they need. That script has been refined time and time again. It wasn't a one and done deal. It was a system that we followed with Thrive in the refining process, and that has obviously the 411% shows that system works.
Yeah. So here's a big one for you. So last week alone, our booking percentage was 91%. We actually booked more deals, more new customers last year than we did the first 5 months. Or I'm sorry, we booked more deals last week than we did the first 5 months of last year from before we worked with Thrive. So again, we booked more deals last week than the first 5 months of last year. And it's incredible. But the reason why we have that success is by implementing the systems that Thrive has taught us and helped us out with. So.
Some of those systems that we've implemented are group interviews. That way we've really been able to come up with a really great team. We've created and implemented checklists. That way everything gets done and it gets done right. It creates accountability. We're able to make sure that everything gets done properly, both out in the field and also in our office. And also doing the podcast, like Jared had mentioned, that has really, really contributed to our success. But that, like I said, the diligence and consistency in doing those in that system has really, really been a big blessing in our lives. And also, it's really shown that we've gotten the success from following those systems. Yeah.
So before working with Thrive, we were basically stuck. Really no new growth with our business. And we're in a rut and we didn't know.
The last 3 years, our customer base had pretty much stayed the same. We weren't shrinking, but we weren't really growing either.
Yeah. And so we didn't really know where to go, what to do, how to get out of this rut that we're in. But Thrive helped us with that. You know, they implemented those systems, that they taught us those systems. They taught us the knowledge that we needed in order to succeed. Now, it's been a grind. Absolutely, it's been a grind this last year. But we're getting those fruits from that hard work and the diligent effort that we're able to put into it. So again, we were in a rut. Thrive helped us get out of that rut. And if you're thinking about working with Thrive, quit thinking about it and just do it. Do the action, and you'll get the results. It will take hard work and discipline. But that's what it's going to take in order to really succeed. So we just want to give a big shout out to Thrive, a big thank you out there to Thrive. We wouldn't be where we're at now without their help.
Hi, I'm Dr. Mark Moore. I'm a pediatric dentist. Through our new digital marketing plan, we have seen a marked increase in the number of new patients that we're seeing every month, year over year. 1 month, for example, we went from 110 new patients the previous year to over 180 new patients in the same month. And overall, our average is running about 40 to 42% increase month over month, year over year. The group of people required to implement our new digital marketing plan is immense, starting with a business coach, videographers, photographers, web designers. Back when I graduated dental school in 1985, nobody advertised. The only marketing that was ethically allowed in everybody's eyes was mouth-to-mouth marketing. By choosing to use the services, you're choosing to use a proven turnkey marketing and coaching system that will grow your practice and get you the results that you're looking for. I went to the University of Oklahoma College of Dentistry, graduated in 1983, and then I did my pediatric dental residency at Baylor College of Dentistry from 1983 to 1985.
Hello, my name is Charles Kolaw with Kolaw Fitness. Today I want to tell you a little bit about Clay Clark and how I know Clay Clark. Clay Clark has been my business coach since 2017. He's helped us grow from 2 locations to now 6 locations. We're planning to do 7 locations in 7 years and then franchise. And Clay has done a great job of helping us navigate anything that has to do with like running the business, building the systems, the checklists, the workflows, the audits, how to navigate lease agreements, how to buy property, how to work with brokers and builders. This guy is just amazing. He's this kind of guy has worked in every single industry. He's written books with like Lee Cockrell, head of Disney, with the 40,000 cast members. He's friends with like Mike Lindell. He does Reawaken America tours, where he does these tours all across the country where 10,000 or more people show up to some of these tours. On the day-to-day, he does anywhere from about 160 companies. He's at the top. He has a team of business coaches, videographers, and graphic designers and web developers, and they run 160 companies every single week. So think of this guy with a team of business coaches running 160 companies. So in the weekly, he's running 160 companies. Every 6 to 8 weeks, he's doing Reawaken America tours. Every 6 to 8 weeks, he's also doing business conferences where 200 people show up, and he teaches people a 13-step proven system that he's done and worked with billionaires, helping them grow their companies. I've seen guys from startups go from startup to being multimillionaires, teaching people how to get time freedom and financial freedom through the system. Critical thinking, document creation, making it, putting it into organizing everything in their head to building into a franchisable, scalable business. Like one of his businesses has like 500 franchises. That's just one of the companies or brands that he works with. So amazing guy, Elon Musk kind of like smart guy. He kind of comes off sometimes as socially awkward, but he's so brilliant and he's taught me so much. When I say that, like Clay is like, he doesn't care what people think when you're talking to him. He cares about where you're going in your life and where he can get you to go. And that's what I like him most about him. He's like a good coach. A coach isn't just making you feel good all the time. A coach is actually helping you get to the best you. And Clay has been an amazing business coach. Through the course of that, we became friends. I was really most impressed with him is when I was shadowing him one time. We went into a business deal and listened to it. I got to shadow and listen to it. And when we walked out, I knew that he could make millions on the deal. And they were super excited about working with him. And he told me, he's like, I'm not going to touch it. I'm going to turn it down. Because he knew it was going to harm the common good of people in the long run. And the guy's integrity just really wowed me. It brought tears to my eyes to see that this guy, his highest desire was to do what's right. And anyways, just an amazing man. So anyways, impacted me a lot. He's helped navigate. Anytime I've got nervous or worried about how to run the company or navigating competition and an economy that's like, I remember we got closed down for 3 months. He helped us navigate on how to stay open, how to get back open, how to just survive through all the COVID shutdowns, lockdowns.
I'm Rachel with Tip Top Canine, and we just want to give a huge thank you to Clay and Vanessa Clark.
Hey guys, I'm Ryan with Tip Top Canine. Just want to say a big thank you to Thrive 15. Thank you to Make Your Life Epic. We love you guys. We appreciate you and really just appreciate how far you've taken us.
This is our old house, right? This is where we used to live 2 years ago. This is our old neighborhood. As you can see, it's nice, right?
So this is my old van and our old school marketing. And this is our old team. And by team, I mean it's me and another guy.
This is our new house with our new neighborhood.
This is our new van with our new marketing, and this is our new team. We went from 4 to 14, and I took this beautiful photo. We worked with several different business coaches in the past, and they were all about helping Ryan sell better and just teaching sales, which is awesome, but Ryan is a really great salesman. So we didn't need that. We needed somebody to help us get everything that was in his head out into systems, into manuals and scripts, and actually build a team. So now that we have systems in place, we've gone from 1 to 10 locations in only a year.
In October 2016, we grossed $13,000 for the whole month. Right now it's 2018, the month of October. It's only the 22nd. We've already grossed a little over $50,000 for the whole month, and we still have time to go. We're just thankful for you, thankful for Thrive and your mentorship, and we're really thankful that you guys have helped us to grow a business that we run now instead of the business running us. Just thank you, thank you, thank you, times a thousand.
The Thrive Time Show, two-day interactive business workshops, are the highest and most reviewed business workshops on the planet.
You can learn the proven 13-point business systems that Dr. Zellner and I have used over and over to start and grow successful companies. I mean, we get into the specific steps on what you need to do to optimize your website. We're going to teach you how to fix your conversion rate. We're going to teach you how to do a social media marketing campaign that works. How do you raise capital? How do you get a small business loan? We teach you everything you need to know here during a two-day, 15-hour workshop. It's all here for you. You work every day in your business, but for 2 days you can escape and work on your business and build these proven systems so now you can have a successful company that will produce both the time freedom and the financial freedom that you deserve. You're going to leave energized, motivated, but you're also going to leave empowered. The reason why I've built these workshops is because as an entrepreneur, I always wish that I had this. And because there wasn't anything like this, I would go to these motivational seminars, no money down, real estate, Ponzi scheme, get motivated seminars, and they would never teach me anything. It was like you went there and you paid for the big chocolate Easter bunny, but inside of it, it was a hollow nothingness. And I wanted the knowledge, and they're like, oh, but we'll teach you the knowledge after our next workshop. And the great thing is we have nothing to upsell. At every workshop, we teach you what you need to know. There's no one in the back of the room trying to sell you some next big get-rich-quick, walk-on-hot-coals product. It's literally, we teach you the brass tacks, the specific stuff that you need to know to learn how to start and grow a business. And I encourage you to not believe what I'm saying, and I want you to Google the Z66 Auto Auction. I want you to Google Elephant in the Room. Look at Robert Zellner and Associates. Look them up and say, are they successful because they're geniuses, or are they successful because they have a proven system? When you do that research, you will discover that the same systems that we use in our own business can be used in your business. Come to Tulsa, book a ticket, and I guarantee you it's going to be the best business workshop ever, and we'll even give you your money back if you don't love it. We've built this facility for you, and we're excited to see you.
If we go back 8 years ago, think about the number of clients you had back then versus the number of clients you have now. As a percentage, what has been the growth over the past 8 years, do you think? We got to inspire somebody out there who just doesn't have the time to listen to their calls.
Okay, so Clay, it's like I would go up and down from about $10,000 a month up to about $40,000. It was up and down roller coaster. And so now we've got it to where we're in excess of 100 clients.
That's awesome.
And so I would have anywhere from 5 clients to 20 clients on my own with networking, but I had no control over it. I didn't. Without the systems, you're gonna be victimized by your own business.
For somebody out there who struggles with math, if you let's say that your average number of clients was 30, and you go to 100, as a percentage, what is that?
I have doubled every year since working with you. So I've doubled in clients, I've doubled in revenue every year. It's 100% growth every year I've worked with. Now, so I'm looking, we've been good friends 7-8 years, and I've got doubled 5 times.
Which is just incredible. I mean, the first time you do it, that's one thing, but when you do it repeatedly,
yeah.
I mean, that's unbelievable.
We're working our blessed assurance off this year to double. We're planning on doubling again. We're incorporating some new things in there to really help us do it, but we are going to double again this year. I started coaching, but it would go up and down, Clay. That's when I came to you, as I was going up and down, and I wanted to go up and up instead of up and down. And so that's when it needed a system. So creating a system is you have nailed down specific steps that you're going to take, no matter how you feel, no matter the results, you lean into them and you do them regardless of what's happened. You lean into them and it will give you X number of leads. You follow up with those leads, turns into sales. Well, I tell you, you know, it's if you don't have a script and you don't have a system, then every day is a whole new creation. You're creating a lot of energy just to figure out what are you going to do.
Right.
And the best executives, Peter Drucker is a father of modern management. He said, the most effective executives make one decision a year. What you do is you make a decision, what is your system, and then you work like the Dickens to make sure you follow that system. And so that's really what it's all about. So with a script here, we have a brand new gal that just came in working for us. She nailed down the script, and
yep.
She's been nailing down appointments. Usually we try to get one appointment for every 100 calls. We make 200 to 300 calls a day per rep.
Right.
And she's been nailing down 5 and 8 appointments a day.
Somebody out there is having a hard time.
On that script.
So she's making how many calls a day?
She's making between 200 and 300 calls a day.
Whoa. And our relationship is weird in that we do, if someone were to buy an Apple computer today,
yeah,
and or let's say you bought a personal computer, a PC, the computer is made by, let's say, Dell. But then the software in the computer would be Microsoft, let's say, or Adobe or whatever that is. So I basically make the systems, and you're like the computer and I'm like the software. It's kind of how I would describe our relationship.
Yeah.
Tim, I want to ask you this. You and I reconnected, I think it was in the year 2000 and what was it, maybe 2010? Is that right? 2011 maybe? Or maybe further down the road. Maybe 2013?
2012.
Okay, so 2012, and at that time I was 5 years removed from the DJ business, and you were how many years removed from tax and accounting software?
It was about 10, 11 years.
We met, how did we re-meet? What was the first interaction? There was some interaction where you and I first connected. I just remember that somehow you and I went to Hideaway Pizza. But do you remember when we first reconnected?
Yeah. Well, we had that speaking thing that...
Oh, there it was. So yeah. It was Victory Christian Center. I was speaking there.
My name is Robert Redmond. I actually first met Clay almost 3 years ago to the day. I don't know if he remembers it or not, but I wasn't working with him at the time. I asked to see him and just ask him some questions to help, you know, direct my life, to get some mentorship. But I've been working with Clay for now just over a year. The role I play here is a business coach, business consultant. I work with different businesses implementing best practice processes and systems that I have learned here by working with Clay. And the experience working here has, to put it real plainly, has been just life-changing. I have not only learned new things and have gained new knowledge, but I have gained a whole new mindset that I believe wherever I end up will serve me well throughout the rest of my life. Since working with Clay, I have learned so much. I mean, I would like to say almost everything about business in terms of the different categories. I haven't learned it all, but I've learned all about marketing. I've learned about advertising. I've learned about branding. I've learned how to create a sales process for organizations in any industry. I've learned how to sell. I've learned how to create repeatable systems and processes and hold people accountable, you know, how to hire people. It's almost like every aspect of a business you can learn, I have learned a lot in those different categories. And then, again, the mindset that I've gained here has been huge. You know, working here, you can't be a mediocre person. You are a call to a higher standard of excellence. And then as you're called to that standard here, you begin to see those outcomes in every area of your life. That standard of excellence that you want to implement no matter what you're involved in. I would like to describe the other people that work with Clay are people that are going somewhere with their life. Marshall in the group interview talks about how you know, the best fits for this organization are the people that are goal-oriented. So they're on their own trajectory, and we're on our own trajectory, And the best fits are those people where there can be a mutually beneficial relationship, that as we pursue our goals and we help the business pursue those goals, the business helps us pursue our goals as well. And so I'd say people that are driven, people that want to make something of their lives, people that are goal-oriented, they're focused, and they're committed to overcoming any adversity that may come their way. Clay's passion for helping business owners grow their businesses is unique in that I don't know if there's anyone else's that can be as passionate. You know, whenever a business starts working with Clay, it's almost as like Clay is running that business in the sense that he has something at stake. You know, he's just serving them. They're one of his clients, but it's as if he is actively involved in the business. Whenever they have a win, he's posting it all over his social media. He's shouting it across the room here at Thrive. You know, he's sending people encouraging messages. He can kind of be that life coach and business coach in terms of being that a motivator and that champion for people's businesses. It's again unique because there's no one else I've seen get so excited about and passionate about other people's businesses. The kind of people that wouldn't like working with Clay are people that are satisfied with mediocrity. People that want to get through life by just doing enough, by just getting by. People who are not looking to develop themselves, people who are not coachable, people who think that they know it all and they're unwilling to change. I would say those are the type of people. And in short, anyone that's content with mediocrity would not like working with Clay. So if you're meeting Clay for the first time, the advice I'd give you is definitely come ready to take tons of notes. Every time Clay speaks, he gives you a wealth of knowledge that you don't want to miss. I remember the first time that I met Clay, I literally carried a notebook with me all around. I was looking at this notebook the other day, actually. I carried a notebook with me all around, and I just took tons of notes. I filled the entire notebook in about 3 or 4 months just from being around Clay, following him, and learning from him. And then I would say, come coachable. Be open to learning something new. Be open to challenging yourself. Be open to learning and adjusting parts about you that need to be adjusted.